You're in Google Sheets right now, I think, and you're trying to find the double underline option. You have a row of numbers and you have summed them, and you want to show that that last number is a sum. And typically you do that by putting a double underline right above it. So if you go to Format and Underline, there's only a regular underline available. If you want to try to do it with double bottom border, there's only a single one right here, so you can't do that either. There are some workarounds though. If you're in Excel, there's a couple of different ways you could do this. If we have a list here and we've summed it, you can't tell by looking at it, right? That's why you give the viewer a clue, and you either do bottom double border, you go to Font and apply a double underline. It's literally style called double underline. You might not have known that was there, it's kind of buried, but it is. So you see the difference between the two. The bottom border takes up the width of the column. Double underline just goes the width of the text in the cell. That'll matter later when we're back in Sheets. So let's go back to Sheets. And here's your list. You want to do a double underline. Here's a couple ways to do it. The first way to do it is to go to the number that you want to double underline on, apply regular underline because that's all you can do, and then do a bottom single bottom border. Now you see that those are two different weights. It's kind of ugly. You can fix it by adjusting the width of the column. I just double clicked, which it looks okay. It's not great. I'm gonna show you another way to do it. Another way to do it would be to have a blank row in the middle and add this up, and then in between where you want to double underline, insert underscores. I'm just holding down the shift key and pressing the dash, which is in between the zero and the equals key. And there's your underscore. You go back to it and you do a strike through, the format strike through. There's another double underline. The align, it wants to align left, so you have to move the alignment to the right. There you go on that one. That one doesn't look great. I mean, it does accomplish giving you a double underline, but the last way to do it, which I think is the best way, is as follows. We're going to leave a blank line again, blank row, and in that blank row we're going to apply bottom border, and then we're going to go up one more and apply bottom border again. And then you can change the height of these rows, left mouse click, drag all the way up. You can just keep dragging, it's not going to get too small. Let go, there you have a double bottom border. So that's probably the best solution. Do keep in mind that that's not perfect solution, because if you type something after the five, it's going to go in a row and you won't be able to see it, and but the sum formula might pick it up, so just be careful when you use it. But this is probably as close as you can get to what you used to be able to do in Excel pretty easily.